Good morning students, today we are going to take the topic electric motor. Now first we should know what is electric motor. Electric motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. You might have seen the motors in the toy, in the water pump, mixer, juicer. Then you might have seen motor in the washing machine. So this is motor which is converting the electrical energy into mechanical energy. Now we will be discussing the DC motor. Now first we should know what is the construction, or you can say what is the electric motor consists of. Here you can see two magnet here that is having north and south pole. Then we have a armature. That armature means the insulated copper wire wound on the soft iron core, that is known as armature. So you can see this is a coil here, A, B, C, D. So large number of turns are there in this armature. The next thing is that is the split ring. Now you can see P and Q, these are the two split rings connected to A and D respectively. This split rings are this like this, but it is divided into two equal parts. This is a ring here. There are two splitting divided into two equal parts, that is half part. You can see this P and Q. And the role of this split ring is to reverse the direction of current, that we will see in the working, that they are also known as commutator because they reverse the direction of current. Now attached to this split ring P and Q, they are, you can see X and Y, they are carbon brush made up of graphite. As you know, graphite is a good conductor of electricity. And they are just touching the split ring. They are not attached to it. They are not joined with the split ring. They are just touching the split ring. And when the split ring rotates, it moves like this. It does not get entangled. The wire, if we not use this carbon brush, and if we directly connect this connecting wire to the split ring, the wire will get entangled and it will break. So these are the, and then it is connected to the battery which will supply the electric current, and here we have a key. So these are the construction of the electric motor. Now we'll discuss the working of it. Before we start the working of the electric motor, let us discuss on which principle does the electric motor work. Now the principle of the working of the electric motor is that whenever a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field and current is passed, it experiences a force, and the direction of the force is given by the Fleming left hand rule. So this force which is experienced on the current carrying conductor when placed in a magnetic field is the basic principle of electric motor. Now let us see how the current enters in the coil. This is a battery. The current starts from here, enters X, then is joined to the split ring P, then moves to A. Current flows from A to B, and then from here C to D, and then it goes to Q and leave it from Y, and the circuit is completed. Now see, when the current flows from A to B, now I'll give an example here. I'll consider that this is a rectangular coil here. This is A and this is B, and this is C and this is D. So when the current enters in the coil from A to B and it is placed perpendicular to the magnetic field, that is this side north to south direction. Magnetic field is from north to south. So when the current flows from A to B and the magnetic field is applied from north to south, you can see the direction here applying left hand rule. This is the current direction of current from here to this side, A to B. And the magnetic field is showing by the index figure, that is from north to south here. If you see this, then you will find that the thumb is pointing downward. That means on the side AB, the force is exerted and it moves downward. And if we see the current from C to D, this is C and this is D, the current flows from C to D, it is, we can see the current is flowing from here to here, from C to D, the magnetic field is from north to south, that is pointing with the index finger or forefinger, and the thumb is pointing the force exerted on this conductor. So the side CD, the force is exerted in upward direction, and here in the side AB, it is exerted in the downward direction. So what happens is it moves like this and takes a half turn. Current is flowing from here and from this side to this side. So this part of AB moves down and this part of CD moves upward direction and it takes a turn. So as you can see in this figure, now the side CD has shifted to this side and B has gone, AB has gone to that side. Along with it, the split ring is also have changed its position. The only thing which is stationary is the carbon brush, that is X and Y. Now the current will flow from here. Now so the direction of current, you can see it will get reversed. Now from the current is moved from X, then it is Q, D, C, B, A, P and Y. Now earlier the current is moving in this direction from A to B and then from C to D. That means it is going from P, then A, B, C, D, then it is going to Q. But here the direction of current is going from Q, D, C, B, A. So the direction of current, as you can see, is changed. So this is due to the split ring, that is P and Q. That is why these are also known as commutator, which reverse the direction of current. Now when the current flows to B to C and from here B to A, that I will show it again. Earlier it was like this and it has half rotation, it has done like this. Now the current is flowing from C to D. This is C and this is D. Sorry, D to C. The current is flowing from B to C. This is D and this is C. So current is flowing here and from here the current is flowing B to A. So when the current is flowing from B to C, again applying the Fleming left hand rule, you can see this DC part will go down, whereas this AB part, this is current is flowing from B to A, it is flowing from B to A, you can see applying Fleming left hand rule, it will going upward. So it will take a turn and its complete rotation will be there. So by this way, it will rotate like this, and this is due to the reversal of current, that is due to the split ring. Now we'll see what is the factor which increases the strength of the motor. That is, first is the number of turns in the armature, and the second is the amount of current, that is if more amount of current is flowing through it, so the strength of the motor will increase, and also the strength of the magnet that we are using. So these are the factors on which the strength of the motor depends.